The modern era of armored vehicle development follows two distinct paths. On one hand, we have entirely new designs, such as the Russian T-14 Armata, incorporating cutting-edge technology. On the other hand, many countries opt for extensive upgrades of older platforms, as seen with the Slovak M55S, which is based on the Cold War-era T-55. Today's video focuses on this latter approach, specifically examining Spain's Tortuga project. This initiative aimed to modernize the Leopardo 2E, Spain's variant of the German Leopard 2A6. After years of service without major upgrades, signs of obsolescence began to surface. Although the Tortuga project was ultimately not adopted, the research and technological advancements from the project will play a crucial role in the future development of the Leopardo 2E M2+, an upcoming modernization package for Spain's main battle tanks. Hello, dear viewer. Tanks Encyclopedia is currently closing in on 100,000 subscribers. With this important milestone in sight, we'd like to remind you to subscribe if you enjoy our content and want to see more. Now, back to the video. The Leopardo 2E is the Spanish variant of the German Leopard 2A6. Although it is highly valued by Spanish tank crews today, its development was somewhat complicated. The idea for the Leopardo 2E arose from the increasing obsolescence of Spain's armored fleet. By 1993, the situation was somewhat chaotic. The most modern vehicles in service were the AMX-30 EM2 and the AMX-30 ER1, Spanish variants of the French AMX-30, developed to address the shortcomings of the original design. In addition, Spain still operated American M48 Patton tanks acquired around 1953, which were completely obsolete by the 1990s. This outdated fleet also included M60A1 and M60A3 TTS tanks, the latter being slightly more modern but still approaching the limits of obsolescence. Before the development of the Leopardo 2E, Spain pursued another tank design in the early 1990s with the same objective. The Forgotten Lynx, or Lynx in English, was a Spanish-German project aimed at creating a fully indigenous battle tank based on the German Leopard 2A4. However, political decisions, program challenges, and competition from other foreign companies ultimately led to the project's cancellation. As for the Leopardo 2E, its origins trace back to a proposal by Spanish Lieutenant Colonel Antonio José Candil Muñoz. In 1993, he conducted a study on the deteriorating state of Spain's armored fleet and recommended that the army acquire German Leopard 2 main battle tanks. In 1994, a Spanish delegation traveled to Germany to negotiate with the German high command regarding the acquisition of these vehicles. These discussions also covered the development of a Spanish variant of the Leopard 2A5, which later evolved into the Leopard 2A6, which ultimately became the Leopardo 2E. These negotiations were highly tense. The German High Command initially refused to supply Spain with Leopard 2 tanks, instead offering the older Leopard 1A5 and even Soviet-era equipment from East Germany. The latter would have posed a significant logistical challenge for Spain due to the difficulty of sourcing spare parts for such an old platform. Ultimately, an agreement was reached. Germany would provide 108 Leopard 2A4 tanks, but only on the condition that the Spanish delegation could persuade German companies to develop an indigenous Leopard 2 variant. After persistent efforts, they succeeded. By 1996, the Leopard 2A4s finally arrived in Spain. In addition to modernizing the Spanish army, they allowed tank crews to familiarize themselves with the Leopard platform in preparation for the Leopardo 2E. These tanks also served as testbeds for components that would later be integrated into the Leopardo 2E. By the late 1990s, the development of the Leopardo 2E project was underway, but it was met with resistance from Spanish companies. The primary opposition came from Santa Barbara Sistemas, which was working on an upgrade program for the Spanish M60 fleet designated the M60A3E1. The issue was clear. If a new Leopard 2 variant was to be introduced, further investment in upgrading the M60s would become redundant. As a result, Santa Barbara Sistemas viewed the Leopardo 2E as a direct threat to their project. Ultimately, the new tank's development led to the cancellation of the M60A3E1 program, causing financial losses for the company. Nevertheless, Santa Barbara Sistemas was eventually selected to develop the new Leopardo 2E in collaboration with the German company Krauss Maffei. The tank would be based on the Leopard 2A6, but adapted to meet the specific requirements of the Spanish Army. While the development process was already complex, the true facepalm moment came with the privatization of Spanish companies. The privatization itself wasn't the issue. The problem was the company was sold to General Dynamics, the manufacturer of American M1 Abrams, and the Leopard 2's direct competitor. The Germans were stunned as they had shared sensitive technical details with the Spanish engineers to facilitate development. Fearing that classified information about their vehicle could fall into the hands of a competitor, they nearly withdrew from the project altogether. The vehicle's development continued, but there were significant cooperation problems. In fact, some Spanish military personnel mentioned that the Spanish engineers were closely monitored by the Germans regarding the measurements they took of the vehicle's armor plates. It was even reported that the ceramic armor plates were stored in a safe that required two keys, one from the Spanish manager and another from the German manager, to open. Despite the challenges, the collaboration ultimately proved successful. The first Leopardo 2Es began to enter service in the early 2000s. While the Spanish Army raised some concerns, such as the vehicle's weight exceeding initial specifications, the Leopardo 2E was and continues to be a highly valued vehicle. As the 2020s progressed, the Leopardo 2E remained unchanged since its introduction. Unlike the other Leopard 2 variants, such as those used by Canada or Poland, which have been upgraded to better counter evolving threats, the Spanish Leopardo 2E retained its original configuration, nearly making it obsolete. Foreseeing this issue, the Spanish Army initiated a study between 2012 and 2015. Analyzing Leopard 2 variants in service worldwide. While the exact purpose of this investigation remains classified, it is likely that the Army sought to assess upgrade programs implemented by other nations to inform potential improvements for its own fleet. During this period, in 2017, an unexpected development occurred within the Guadarrama 12th Brigade. A group of soldiers led by a tank commander named Lopez independently began modifying one of their Leopardo 2Es. Their goal was to propose an upgrade package to the Spanish Army, offering a potential solution to the growing obsolescence of the fleet. The prototype, named Tortuga, Spanish for turtle or tortoise, was an adaptation of the Leopardo 2E designed around urban combat. Estimated to weigh around 64 tons, the design was influenced by lessons learned from the poor performance of Turkish Leopard 2A4s during the Battle of Al-Bab in 2016. In response, the Tortuga incorporated a total of 50 improvements aimed at enhancing survivability and effectiveness in urban warfare. However, as a relatively recent and classified project, not all of these upgrades have been publicly disclosed. The most notable modification of the Tortuga prototype is its improved protection, featuring spaced slat armor added to both the chassis and turret. This armor was tested using a mock-up subjected to a high-penetration guided missile, though the exact model remains undisclosed due to the project's confidentiality. Additionally, the turret received extra armor on its sides, and a bar was welded to its roof to cut cables that might obstruct the commander's and loader's hatches. The chassis was also upgraded with armored boxes at the front to protect sensors and lights, addressing a common vulnerability in combat, where damage to these components, while not disabling the tank, could significantly reduce its effectiveness. The Tortuga prototype was also equipped with a camouflage cover matching the camouflage pattern of Spanish tank crew uniforms. This addition aimed to improve crew survivability during maintenance operations outside the vehicle. By reducing the contrast between the crew and the tank, the camouflage made it harder for snipers or hostile infantry to distinguish personnel from the vehicle, decreasing the likelihood of them being targeted. The main cannon of the Tortuga prototype remained unchanged, but it received modern targeting systems, including a friend or foe identification system and new laser designators. The secondary armament was upgraded by replacing the 7.62mm MG3 machine gun on the turret roof with a 12.7mm M2HB machine gun. This new weapon was also equipped with a flash suppressor, a laser designator, and a South Korean DCL-110 holographic sight. Although the M2HB was initially intended to be manually operated, the Spanish defense company Escribano, known for its modular turrets and defense systems, proposed integrating it into their Guardian 2.0 remotely controlled weapon system. While plans and renders were presented, the upgrade itself was ultimately shelved due to the extensive time required to implement this modification. The engine of the Tortuga prototype remained unchanged, but new thermal deflectors were added to make it more difficult to detect with thermal imaging cameras. However, with all of the added armor and equipment, the Tortuga experienced reduced mobility compared to the original Leopardo 2E. Several additional modifications were considered but never ultimately implemented. These included a polymer plate on the underside of the tank to enhance crew protection against anti-tank mines and a battering ram mounted on the front of the chassis to clear obstacles and debris during urban combat. Although the Tortuga prototype was never officially adopted by the Spanish Army, it did undergo testing. The vehicle was trialed at the National Training Center of San Gregorio during the Advanced Frontier Exercise in June 2017. The purpose of these trials was to evaluate the prototype's performance and determine which upgrades might be worth implementing on the Leopardo 2E. After the project concluded, the Tortuga prototype was dismantled and reverted to its original Leopardo 2E configuration. The results of the study remain classified, but it is believed that the findings will help shape the future development of the Leopardo 2E M2 Plus upgrade program. The Leopardo 2E M2 Plus is a new upgrade project initiated by the Spanish Army with the goal of enhancing the existing Leopardo 2E fleet. The first vehicles are expected to be deployed around 2032. While the upgrades are still under study, it is anticipated that the Leopardo 2E M2 Plus will feature significant improvements, including the more powerful L55A1 cannon, remotely controlled weapon system stations, and active protection systems. In parallel, Lopez, the figure behind the original Tortuga prototype, is independently working on what might be referred to as the Tortuga 2. Though no physical prototype exists as of yet, Lopez has been refining the design using 3D models of the Leopardo 2E and incorporating new upgrades compared to the initial Tortuga project. The Tortuga 2 is highly confidential, with no details available regarding its appearance, upgrades, or the intentions behind its development. In conclusion, while the Tortuga prototype was never adopted, it stands as a precursor to the Leopardo 2E M2 Plus, which will likely become the next generation main battle tank for the Spanish Army. The Tortuga served as a testbed for refining various upgrades that could inform the development of the Leopardo 2E M2 Plus. We extend our sincere thanks to the Guadarrama 12th Brigade and especially to Lopez for sharing invaluable information that has previously been lost or unreleased. Thank you very much. If you haven't done so already, we invite you to subscribe to stay updated on future content. If you'd like to contribute further, consider supporting us on Patreon or PayPal. We want to especially thank our medium and heavy tank Patreon supporters: Dan Fitzpatrick, Dave Schuford, Leslie Hulkauer, Michael Herman, Owen M., and Wolfund. Your generous contributions help fund our research, illustrations, and video production. Until next time, keep us in your sights.